Hello, and welcome to another tutorial about Linux and virtual machines. Today, I want to give an introduction to networking in KVM. What are bridged connections? How are they different than the default NAT option? And how to define a connection for each of these types?
So when we create a new virtual machine, we usually want it to be able to access the internet. So let's say that this is a given. But do we want to expose it to our local network? Here, there is no one-size-fits-all answer. In some cases, being able to access the local network is absolutely necessary, whereas in other cases, we might not want it.
And that's basically the defining characteristic of a bridged network. It allows access from the virtual machine to the local network, something that with the default NAT connection, we don't have.
So if I open one of my virtual machines, and I click on its NIC, I can see that its network source is the virtual network default, which is NAT.
So what is a NAT? First, let's say a few words about source and destination in the context of IP networks.
Let's say that we have a client computer, a host, and this host needs to make a request to a server, which is far, far away in a different network. The communication is carried out via the internet, of course.
IP communication is based on IP packets. These packets hold actual data, but they also contain, among other things, two IP addresses, the source and the destination.
This way, when the server gets the request, it knows the source of this request and can create its own IP packet and this time use this address as the destination. But this example assumed that the host used a public IP. As you probably know, most of the computers don't have a public IP. They access the internet via a router, and their IP only has meaning within the network defined by this router. That's why the IP of a computer is usually 192.168.something.something or 10.0.something.something. These addresses are local addresses and are not exposed to the internet.
So what does all of this have to do with NAT?
NAT stands for Network Address Translation.
As we said, the host has its local IP address, and then the router has a public IP address. When the host sends a packet, it's actually sent to the router. Then NAT kicks in and the router replaces the source IP address from the local address to the public address.
From this point on, during the journey of the packet, it seems like the origin of the packet is the router and not the specific host where it actually originated from. In a similar fashion, when the reply gets back to the router uses NAT again and replaces the public IP with the local IP of the specific host.
Virt-manager operates pretty much in the same way. When we install qemu and kvm, we get two new virtual hardware devices, a virtual router and a virtual switch.
If we take a look at virt-manager network configuration, we can see that we have a network called default. This default network uses its own virtual router, and its hosts, which are the virtual machines, get their IPs from the DHCP service in this virtual router. We can have many virtual machines, and as long as they belong to the default network, they belong to the same local network, behind the same virtual router.
To be able to connect more virtual machines to the virtual router, we also have a virtual switch, which simply allows more devices in the same network, or in our case, more virtual machines behind the same virtual router.
So we started with a physical computer connected to a physical router, which in turn is connected to the internet. Once we install qemu and kvm, we get our virtualization environment, which includes the default virtual network consisting of a virtual router and a virtual switch. We can then create virtual machines, and connecting them to the default virtual network simply means plugging them into the virtual switch. So if we have two virtual machines running, and they're both connected to the default network, they have IP addresses in the range allocated by the virtual router. Moreover, they will be able to see each other, and I can ping one VM from the other. But since my physical host is not in the network defined by the virtual router, its IP address is going to be outside of this range. So it cannot ping any of the guest virtual machines, and the guest cannot ping the host. When we run IP ADDR on the host computer, we can see virbr0. Virbr is short for virtual bridge, which is just another name for the virtual switch. As for virbr0-nic, it's just a dummy Ethernet nic so that the bridge will have at least one network device attached to it, and it can be ignored. Each running virtual machine will add another VNet entry, which is the virtual NIC of the virtual machine. We can also see that the virtual bridge itself has an IP within the range of the virtual router DHCP, because it serves as the gateway for the virtual machines. By using the command bridge control show, we can see a list of the bridges currently defined. And we can see that we currently only have one bridge, virbr0, and its interfaces are connected to the dummy NIC and to the virtual NICs of each of the virtual machines. If we don't want our virtual machines to be able to see each other, we can always create additional NAT networks. And we can configure the DHCP range. Then we can attach each of the virtual machines to either the default network or the other network. But what if we want to be able to access the host from the guests and vice versa?
For this, we need a bridged network. But here comes a heads up. For a bridged network to work in virt-manager, we need the host, the physical computer, to be connected using an Ethernet cable. I didn't succeed to do it with Wi-Fi, and I don't know if it's possible. But even if you don't have an Ethernet port on your computer, not all is lost. You can always grab one of these. They are quite cheap, and they let you connect an Ethernet cable to a USB port. So you can use one of your USB ports as if it was an Ethernet port.
Another option, if you really don't want to use one of these, and you need the bridged connection anyway, you can use VirtualBox as your virtualization tool. Bridged connections are possible there, even with Wi-Fi.
I do have an Ethernet port in my computer, and I'm going to just plug in this Ethernet cable.
The difference between the NAT virtual network and the bridge network is that the bridge network doesn't use a virtual router. What we're going to do instead is to create a new switch, then attach our physical NIC, our physical Ethernet port, as a slave to this switch. Our host will be connected to the internet via this switch, and we will also use the switch for our virtual machines. This way, they will share the same local network and will get their IPs from the physical router. To define the new switch or bridge, I'm going to use NM2E, which is the Network Manager Textual User Interface. First, let's deactivate the Wi-Fi network. I only want to use the wired connection. Now, let's create a new bridge. The default name under device is NM bridge, and I leave it this way. Now, I'm going to add the Ethernet as a slave to this bridge. One more thing we need to do is remove the direct wired connection. And let's quit NM2E. We now need to give it about 10 to 15 seconds for the bridge to get connected through the Ethernet cable. And now let's run IP-ADDR again. We can see that the Ethernet itself doesn't have an IP address. But we have a new bridge, NM bridge, which does have an IP address. Let's run bridge control show. And we can see the new bridge in addition to what we had before. And we can also see that it has the Ethernet as its interface. Let's close all of the virtual machines as well as virt-manager itself. All we have to do now is change the NIC configuration for any virtual machine we want to be part of the bridge connection. And of course, I chose the bridge we just defined. Once the virtual machine loads, it's going to take a minute or so for it to configure itself. And when it's done, we can take a look at its network. And you can see that it now belongs to the network defined by the physical router. And we can also ping the physical machine.
Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.